Hi, I'm Dr. Asia Rieger, and welcome to our Introduction to Flow Cytometry series. In today's episode, we're going to go over the very basics of flow cytometry. This will encompass everything from how flow cytometer works to why we use this technology and what we can learn from the data. So if we break down the name flow cytometry, we get an idea of what the technology is and how it works. So metry is measurement, cytome, cells, flow, fluid. So flow cytometry is the measurement of cells in a fluid flow. And what we're looking at in terms of these cells are the characteristics of them, including things like light scatter or fluorescence signatures. When we talk about measuring characteristics of cells, in flow cytometry, we're specifically measuring the characteristics of single cells as they pass through a laser beam of light. And that really is what gives flow cytometry its power and is one of the main reasons why people use this technology. With the power of analyzing single cells, what we're given is a specific distribution of expression across a population of cells. So this is in contrast to, say, a Western blot, which also can be used to analyze protein, where you have a population of cells that you lyse to look to see if your protein is present. However, during this process, all the information from the cells in that population are pooled together. It is an average of expression. In flow cytometry, the individual cells stay intact, and we're able to analyze each cell individually, looking at the expression of that protein in each individual cell. To give a visual representation to this, you can see that with the Western blot, we can detect a band of protein signal. We don't know if we have a small number of cells expressing a very large amount of protein, or, on the opposite side, if we have all the cells expressing a very low amount of the protein, as these two scenarios in an average population could look the same. However, with flow cytometry, we can dissect these dynamics, and we can look at shifts in not only the level of protein expressed on a per-cell basis, but also the proportion of cells in each of these classes, looking at the shifts between the negative and the positive populations. A benefit of using flow cytometry is that you can analyze data from hundreds of thousands of cells in a short period of time, and this makes your data statistically robust. This is in contrast to microscopy, which also analyzes single cells, and those single cells, you get much more detail per cell. However, fewer cells are analyzed, which makes that data less statistically robust. So when we think about the details that we get from the cells in flow cytometry versus, say, microscopy, I like to use a candy analogy. So you can imagine cells in a flow cytometer are kind of like multicolored glowing gumballs. They're circles, and you get details on the colors that they are, but not really where those colors are coming from. In a microscopy image, you actually have the spatial resolution to look at where all those individual signals are coming from, which gives you a better picture of that cell. Every flow cytometer you encounter will have the same basic components. They all will have fluidics, optics, and detectors and electronics. Fluidics is the system in the flow cytometer that is involved in taking your cells from the sample up through the machine. I would say it's one of the most important parts of a flow cytometer because poorly functioning fluidics will give you bad data every single time. The optics are the exciting part of a flow cytometer. So these are the lasers and the filters that are involved in detecting the signals that you've added to your cells. And finally, we have the detectors and the electronics. And these are what take the light signals from your cells and convert them into an electronic signal that the computer can read, giving you your data. In the upcoming videos, we'll go into each of these areas in more detail. So subscribe to our channel and click that little bell icon so you don't miss out on anything. The last thing we're going to talk about are the types of flow cytometers you might encounter when you start doing your work. So first and foremost are going to be the analyzers. These are what you think of as your standard flow cytometer. They will give you your scatter reading from your cells, as well as various fluorescent readings. Now, when you're planning your experiments on your analyzers, it's always important to check the optical configuration of your analyzer, as they are not all the same. And you may end up using fluorochromes that your instrument can't actually detect. Another common class of flow cytometers are the sorters. Now these are similar to an analyzer, but contain components that allow you to actually sort or choose cells out of a mixed population and take them into separate pure populations. And the last class are the imaging cytometers, which is a fun hybrid of a microscope and a flow cytometer, where in every cell that goes by, instead of the light detail being captured by a PMT or a photodiode, it's captured by a camera. And so you actually get images of every cell that goes through the machine, allow you to combine the statistical robustness of flow cytometry with the spatial resolution of microscopy. And as you follow us more, you will hear more and more about this, because this is personally my favorite kind of flow cytometer. And with that, that brings today's video to a close. Thanks for joining us, and make sure you hit that subscribe button and click the little bell icon so you can stay with us on our journey through introduction to flow cytometry. Have a good one.